Hello, good morning everyone. So I see we have for now 11 attendees, so let's just wait a few minutes to give time to a few more people to join us.
Yeah, morning everyone. Welcome. Hi, good morning everyone. So welcome to the last of the three webinars that NSOE is doing for promoters. So today we'll be covering the completion of project sheets. Leading you through that will mostly be Leah. So Leah de Hort, she's the head of the editors team here at NSOE.
Good morning, everyone.
You'll be hearing a lot from her today, but if at any point during the day or during the webinar, rather, you feel like either asking a question or need some clarification, please don't hesitate to ask. You can either raise your hand in the attendees panel and I'll see it. So Leah will be doing the presentation, the demonstration of the project sheets. I'll be taking on, let's say, like question observation duty. So morning, Thierry. So anyone that if at any point you need clarification or want to question, either type it into the question box or alternatively raise your hand. We're happy to answer any questions and give clarification where needed. Okay, next slide, later, Leah. All right, so what are we doing today is looking at just a basic definition of what are actual project sheets, just to give everyone a reminder, just in case there was no one that's been part of previous TYNDPs. Also, just to refresh any old timers' memory. We have a quick look at the TYNDP development timeline. A lot has changed since the TYNDP 2020 started, obviously, and a lot has changed since then, especially with COVID. For those of you who've attended the last two webinars, this will be no new information, but it is good just to refresh, just to kind of finalize that aspect. We'll be looking at the practical guide, where you can find it. It's been published for a while now. It is a pretty decent resource to look at. Leah spent a lot of time putting that together, and it's an easy read. It'll also give you any information that this webinar won't cover, or that we skip over for time reasons. So please take a look at that when you can. We'll be looking at the current status of the project sheets. So where we are, the development status, what functionality is still missing, what functionality still needs to be added. We have how you can preview your project sheets. So right now that feature is a live feature. We have the information that still needs to be completed by you in the project sheets. We'll be running you through that. The mandatory information that we require from you that is not necessarily optional, like say for instance, project level benefits are, but like information that actually needs to be provided by you to us. And then we'll have a look at the CBA indicator tab. Because that is obviously of the highest interest to you guys. We'll be looking at how to submit a project level benefit. This is just going to be a very basic kind of look at like the fields and stuff that are available within that project level benefit tab. And then to round it off, everything else will just be additional information to be added to the project sheets. Okay, that's enough from me. Leah, if you want to take over, I'll mute myself, and then everyone else, if you just want to ask questions, I'll jump in when necessary.
Yes, thank you, Johannes. So yes, as Johannes was saying, don't hesitate to interrupt with questions, and we'll be happy to answer. So a quick reminder, so about the project sheet, so there are the public information that will be published on your project. They will be published with the draft UNDP 2020 package. For now, the publication is planned in October 2020. Why it's important to complete the information we ask for, so part of this information is mandatory, but most importantly, the project sheets, they're really a communication tool. So they are what the European Commission and the PCI regional groups will look at. So if you are planning to apply for PCI status, it is definitely important to really look at your project sheets and complete whatever you can complete. They will be downloadable as PDF and also published on the internet for everyone to see. So when anyone enters your project name in Google, for example, it is likely that among the first few links they will find, there will be the project sheets of your project in this UNDP, the previous ones and the next ones. So the deadline we've set to provide information is the end of June. Why so early, you're probably wondering, is mostly because the information we ask for, it's not really nothing complicated. It's information you already have, mostly. Should you be in a situation where for some reason you are missing information for now and you think you might have it later than the end of June, please let us know, because it could still be possible to complete and add additional information later. But for now, we keep this deadline on the end of June. So a quick look at the timeline to see where we are now. So now in May, we will soon release the IUSN package. Then the deadline to provide information on the project sheets is the end of June. You are also in the window to submit the project level indicators until the end of July. And then we will publish the draft project sheets in October together with the CBA results. So for now, if you have had a look at your project sheets already, you will see that the part with the results is empty. I mean, it's only zeros. The results will become available. For now, it is planned in all of them should be available in September. So we will share them with you. I think earliest in September, but and at the latest 2 weeks before we publish them with the draft UNDP package. So that's the minimum time frame that's set in the guidance for promoters. 2 weeks before is the minimum time you will have. I think most likely it's going to be more time than that. And once you will have the results, you will have the opportunity to provide comments and to publish these comments in the project sheets. But we'll share more information on this later. Yes?
Just quickly before we continue, just Mark Pierce is asking for clarification of what IOSN means.
Oh, Mark, yeah, that's a good point.
Yeah, so it's identification of system needs. Sorry, Leah.
Yeah, so that's the what we call the needs package. It's a series of reports to be published next month, I think around the end of July. And basically looking at where could additional infrastructure increase benefits at European level. So it's a study that's part of the UNDP. It was released for the first time, I think, in the last UNDP 2018. If you want more information, maybe we can exchange via email. Okay.
If there are any questions that we can't answer correctly here, then feel free to email me like this.
Okay, so the practical guide to complete the project sheets, this is the go-to document. So it lists all the information that is mandatory to provide, all the information that is optional, and it also shows you where to fill it in and how. So if you have any question, any remark about this document, please let us know, because if you spot something that's missing or a mistake or anything, then we will edit it and publish an improved version. So please maybe take a look and let us know. So here you have the URL, it's on the TeamADP website, on the page Promoters Corner. A quick note on the draft project sheet. So the version that is available for you right now is very close to final, but there are a few functionalities that are not developed yet. Mainly, there will be a possibility to download it in PDF. So both for you and once they are published for anyone, basically. So what will be in the PDF is all the content of the project sheets minus the video, if you have one, and the pictures, if you choose to upload pictures. The functionality to upload pictures, that's also something that's being developed right now. It will be also possible to download the CBA results in Excel, and actually to download not only the CBA results in Excel, but also more all information about the projects. We will add what we call the project sheet explainers. So these are sort of pop-up window that when you click, for example, someone wants to know what is the indicator B1 social and economic welfare, then there is a window opening explaining in a few words what it is and where to find more information. So there will be quite a few of these on key parts of the project sheets. So these are really meant for external people that really don't know about the TeamADP or maybe about transmission or storage and that want to understand how we assess the project and what is each information that is presented in the project sheets. And then additionally, we will also work on improving the responsiveness of the sheets. If you've tried to access it from your mobile phone, most likely you weren't able to really see the content. So we will be working on this. Now, we will go to the practical demonstration. So I hope some of you have already taken a look. So this is the platform. To access your project sheets, you go to either transmission or storage. You go to your project and you see here, two buttons. So this gray button is to edit the information on your project. The white button is to view your project sheet. Anything you edit in here will automatically appear here once it is saved. So it is just a matter of seconds. So the project sheet is divided in three parts. You have key information, project description and context, and project assessment. This part, key information, is really to give an overview of your project. So we start with really keywords here, then description, a video, if you have uploaded one. If you don't upload a video, then this will just disappear. Then the promoters, the countries, the map. Is the project in an NDP? Is there any other information, like for example, a link to the project website? And the project sheet backlog, this is new in this tier NDP. Mostly we will publish here any change that is made to the project sheet in between the time when we publish the draft package in October and the time when the TeamADP becomes final after the publication of ACER opinion. So for example, if we have to make a correction for whatever reason, we will specify it here. But this is for transparency reasons. Then project description and context is mostly technical information, so the description of each investment. So this is the main investment of your project and these are the other investments. The reason for investment clustering that you have completed back in the submission window in November is the project in the reference grid. The system needs part, we'll come to that later, that will come once we publish the identification of system needs study in July. You will be asked to select, if you want to select a few needs that your project addresses. But we will provide more information on this part later. And then interconnection targets, that's to be completed by ENSOE. Then the last part, the project assessment. So that's the NTCs and the CBA results. The results are ordered per scenario. So here you cannot see the first indicators B1 to B6 because this is a test project. But if you have had a look at your project and you can look at any other project that is submitted, you will see B1, B2, B3, B4, B5, B6, and all results in these columns. I mean, there are no results so far, but once they are made available to you, you will see the results there. You can also see the project level indicators. So for example, this is one. And there you can see all the information that was submitted by the promoter. Then on a scenario, if you submit project level indicators based on other scenarios than the TNEP scenarios, they appear here. And there are some indicators that are not dependent on a scenario. So these two showing up here. Here you will have the opportunity to comment once we release the CBI results. Then information on the residual impact, which we will discuss later today, and the project cost. So it was just to give you an overview. I'll go back to the slides now. Johannes, there is no other question at this stage, or should I stop for a few minutes?
Sorry, no, there's not. There's not. No.
Okay, good.
So if there's any other questions you have, just type them in the question window. If there's something that I can answer myself, I'll answer immediately in the question window. Otherwise, if it's something that can be of benefit to every promoter, then we can raise it. Also, feel free to raise your hand. What we did yesterday in the storage webinar is that I would unmute you. You can then have the opportunity to ask a question in person, and then we can run through it. That way it's recorded, and then we have a record of it in the national webinar recording as well.
Okay, I will move on then. So what information do we still need from you? So it belongs to one of three categories. So mainly mandatory information that is specified in the CBA guideline. So this is, for example, information on the residual impact and on the CAPEX. If you want to submit one, there are the project level indicators, but I won't cover this today because it's been covered in two other webinars last week and yesterday. And so if you want information on these project level indicators and you've missed the webinars, you can go to our website on the TNDP page and you will find the recordings. So they are both already published, and the slide sets. And then the last category is information that we need only for communication purpose, so meaning to improve the way your project is presented. So this includes, for example, for you to edit the description of your project, to provide additional information like the website of the project, to upload the video, this kind of information.
Leah?
Yes.
We have a question from Mark Howard about what we mean with residual impact.
So this is specified in the CBA guideline, the third version. So I do not have the exact definition in mind, but basically it's any impact that's not already covered by other indicators. But I encourage you to go check the CBA guideline for the exact definition. So this is mandatory, meaning if the project has a residual impact, you have to mention it. So there can be three sorts, social impact, environmental impact, or any other residual impact. I will show you in the platform what it looks like.
Just a quick question, because Mark had asked this question yesterday in the storage webinar. So currently the storage response time is only about the actual response of the system itself, but you raised the point of that not covering the inertia.
What
the question is,
I think it's about a separate indicator. Maybe we can start first do the residual impact and then we'll move on to that.
Okay, cool.
I think because it's a different part. So the residual impact, if you see it here, so It is mandatory to specify if there is one. You have to indicate it per investment. So you select one investment. You have to indicate a distance in kilometer for which there is an impact, and select the type of sensitivity in the list. So please really check the CBA guideline, because it really explains why there is this list and what each of these categories mean. So please check the guideline, and then it's just a matter of selecting the investment and entering the kilometers. This disclaimer appears here only when the investment is either planned but not permitting or under consideration. I think if I select another investment that's in permitting, it doesn't show. So that's also a rule that's set in the guidelines, so that's automatic. The principle is the same for the social impact. So per investment, enter the distance in kilometer, and there are also different types of sensitivity to complete. And other residual impact is really, I mean, it's really optional, and that's only text. So there is no categories to choose from on that one. Is there any other question on the residual impact? No, I mean, if there are other questions later, you can still ask.
Not the I think the question is more along the lines of whether, let's say, if there are impacts or benefits that the projects can't, that we can't include in the given list of project level benefits that the project promoters have to upload, whether they can include those in the residual impact, or whether
an impact is not a benefit. I mean, the project level benefits and the social impact they're totally different things.
Okay, no, she has answered the question.
And so I just go back to my slide to be sure not to miss anything. So then another mandatory category is system stability. So that's only relevant for transmission projects. So that's this part. So it should be really easy to fill in. Basically, what we need you to do is just select per investment, indicate what type of element it corresponds to. So there is a drop-down list to choose from. So new AC line, new HVDC, blah, blah, blah. And automatically, the system will allocate a qualitative indicator. So the qualitative indicator per type of element, they are set in the CBA guideline. So that's not something that can be changed. And then once you've completed this, it will appear under the CBI results in the indicators that are not dependent on the scenario. So it will appear here for each investment of your project. So this is really easy to complete. I mean, once you know what type of element correspond to each investment, it only takes a few seconds. So I really encourage you to do it. Because I mean, it's just one other indicator.
Leah, we just have two more questions.
Yes. Yes.
So we have so Philippe asks: residual impacts were assessed by external component by external consultants in T18. Is it planned as well for TYNDP 2020?
No, there is no assessment by external consultant this time. So this it's only what I showed. So the promoter selects the per investment. So there is no external assessment.
Okay. Then there's also a question from Thierry, which is the information purely declarative, or do we need to provide studies as backup?
No, this is declarative. So on this, we don't ask study. I mean, promoters are responsible for what they indicate in the project sheets. So, I mean, we have no way to check that. We trust that you indicate correct information. And yeah, just remember, this is going afterwards to the PCI process and to the EC and ACER.
Okay. So that answers the questions. Then please let me know if at any point we have answered a question, or if you still require some clarification as well. It does help. Okay, sorry there.
So last category is the life cycle capex. That's also specified in the CBA guideline. On the right page. So you can find it on the same tab, CBA indicator at the very bottom. And it's also to be specified per investment. So for each investment, we need to know the capex that's incurred after the commissioning, let's say. So the capex you entered in the submission window was from the project inception until the commissioning, so basically for the construction. And this capex for the life cycle is after that. So for the whole, all the life of the project or of the investment, actually. So you have to enter it for each investment. This is mandatory. And it will appear in the project sheets with the cost in a separate column. So for an exact definition of what means the life cycle capex, please refer to the CBA guideline. I think that there is a whole part on how to compute the capex. Okay. I see no question on this point. Johannes, correct me if I'm wrong.
Oh, what? No, you mean questions? No, no questions yet. Oh. At least no new ones. Oh no, here we go. So there is one. Sorry. From Philip. Philippe. Have you ever tested PDF generation because it does not work with Firefox and Internet Explorer on my laptop? But that might be a personal issue.
Oh, but it's still being developed. That's why. So we are still working on that part. I assume you've been trying from. I think there should be a button somewhere here, but we're still working on it. So it's totally normal that for now it does not work because it's not totally developed. It should become available sometime around mid-June, or definitely before the end of June.
Okay. I think that is it for now. Please, if I'm skipped over one of your questions, just let me know. The question window isn't exactly easy to read when you're short sighted. Okay.
Okay. So then I move on to the information that we really recommend that you provide, but that is not strictly mandatory, meaning that it's not specified in the CBA guideline. So this information, the reason we ask for it is for two reasons. The first one is for consistency with the ASER PCI monitoring. So we need to have a consistent list of categories for the field type of element, because when we asked for information back in November in the submission window, the categories were not exactly aligned with the categories used by ASER. So that's why now we have tried to align it, and we ask you to specify this again for each investment. And then another thing, which was actually a suggestion from ACER, is that a project could specify whether the project is it a totally new infrastructure, or is it mostly new, an upgrade, or mostly an upgrade. So these are the two things that we just ask for consistency with ACER. And then all the other fields are really to improve the communication on the project. So if you already have a video available on your project and it's on YouTube, we just need the link. Soon you will also have the possibility to upload pictures. By pictures, it can be like photographs or maybe even slides, transformed into JPEG or PDF could be uploaded, and we would show them on the project sheet. You could edit your project description. You can add some more information on the project if you want some external people to go to your website or to go to a study that's been published or to go to the PCI page, anything you can think about. You could add information on related projects. So by related, I mean, for example, a reinforcement that's needed for your project to be developed or the other way around. Or for a storage project, the transmission line that's needed to connect them to the grid, or you know this kind of interrelations. If you want to, and for example, there has been a change in the data that you provided in November, so you cannot change now the data that's been provided back in November in the submission window because it's being used for the CBA. But if there has been an update and you want people and the commission to know about it, you can use these fields. So we'll not use this data for the CBA. So this is really just for communication purposes. And last thing, if you want, you can upload the logo of the promoter and it will appear on all your projects. So I will show you now how to do all that. So all this information is grouped here in this tab, additional information for the project sheets. You see here, you will see the definition that you uploaded back in the submission window in November, and you can edit it as you want. This information appears on the very beginning of your project sheet. This is the really first thing people will see. So our advice is to not go straight away into technical detail, but have a more general description about, you know, why this project, what's the purpose, what does it bring in terms of expected benefits, maybe what are the promoters, you know, which countries are concerned, you know, to give a general idea, let's say. Then additional information, so typically it's the website. You can also, maybe if you want to provide some more explanation, put a link to a study, really anything you want. This is the field to align with Acer. So per investment, you just select in the drop-down list. These are all the available categories. And this information will be the one appearing here for the main investment. That's important to keep in mind that if you don't complete it, this will be empty and it will appear here as well. So actually this one is quite important to complete. So this normally is not something you can complete, but you know, we have the second submission window planned in July after the release of the needs package, and if other projects are submitted, then they will have the label future projects. So this is why this is here, but it's not something you can, you should be concerned about. The type of project, is it an upgrade or a new project? Same as the type of element, this appears here. So on the very top of the project sheet. Then the video, we've chosen to only allow the link to YouTube. Because it's a widely used format, so it shouldn't be a problem for anyone. In the case where you do not have a video yet, but you think maybe in the coming few months you might have one and it would be still in time for the release of the package, please let us know, because it's even if it's after the end of June, we could still just add a link in here. Then related projects, so you know, use this field to mention the project number and the name of the related projects and maybe explain a little how they are related to your project. And this last field, finally, as I was saying, if any other information has become available that you would like the PCI regional groups or more widely the general public to know about, this is the place where you can put it in. Is there any question?
Not at the moment, Leona. There's none.
Okay, so maybe I was really clear.
I think you're very clear, yes.
Maybe we can give attendees a few minutes in case they have questions, because I know it can take a little time. So
yeah, we can do that. Yeah.
So let's say until 9:30. I hope everyone has been able to open your project sheets and already take a look. If for some reason you're having technical issues, please let us know and we will see how we can help you.
Maybe you can tell them on which browser the project platform is optimized for.
Personally, I always use Chrome and I never had any issue. So I would recommend Chrome, but I mean, I never use any other type of navigator. So I wouldn't know. Maybe it's also really efficient on Explorer.
Yeah, it could be.
This was a tricky question, Johannes.
Oh, sorry. Fair enough. So in case everyone is confused, just use Chrome in general for everything. Use only Internet Explorer to download Chrome, then uninstall it from your system.
Yeah. Maybe one thing, I don't know if we've showed this to you before, but on the TUNEP website, we have this page, which is really dedicated to information for promoters. And on this page, it's important for you to know you can find all information about the project sheets. So for now, you only have the practical guide, but after this webinar, we will upload here the recording and the slides. And if there is any updated version of this guide, it will also appear here. So it will replace this one. You can find here the recordings of the two webinars on the project level indicators. The slides of yesterday's webinar are still missing, but I will add them soon. And you also have the implementation guideline.
Yeah, for those of you that yesterday's webinar, I promised you to send them. Oh, sorry, no, continue later. Sorry. I'll make my
announcement. No, go ahead. Go ahead.
Fair enough. Thank you. I was just going to say, for those of you who are in yesterday's webinar, I promised to upload the slides, to send the slide deck, as well as the link to the recording, I think within 2 hours after the webinar finished. That was my amateurish knowledge. I didn't know that it took so long for the video to process. So it's the email that's coming today.
Yeah. But in any case, the recording, you already have it here. And
that was last.
Here you can find the guidance for promoters. So the document that we published in September, but it sets all the rules, and it's still very much relevant. So yeah, this was just a reminder. I do not see any other question. Unless
as far as I can tell, no. It seems that they already have a very in-depth knowledge of what the project sheets are. I don't even know what we're doing here, to be honest.
Yes.
I'm just joking.
So if there are no more questions, then I propose that we end this webinar here. And if you think of anything else, any other question you have for us, please don't hesitate to contact us.
Yep. One last check. There are no more questions, Leah. So I think you were very clear.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, thank you, everyone. Thank you, Johannes.
Welcome. Thank you, everyone. Thanks for joining. We hope this was informative, and we look forward to receiving your questions or your at any point in the future. I'm more than happy to answer them. In case there's anything we missed here, please let us know. And we'll upload the video as soon as it becomes available.
Thank you.
Bye.